During my last video on the LE32A336, where I removed the IC from the TCON PCB on the screen, I got a few questions from viewers on how did I remove that IC. I actually used my RE-7500 jig for removing it, which heated up the PCB, and then I brought over top heater to remove the IC. It minimizes the damage to the pads of the printed circuit board. But I know everybody hasn't got one of these jigs. There is another way I used to use, and that is using this gas soldering tool. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to first of all put some flux on the chip, just a little bit, to help it on its way. Now you have to be careful with these ICs. Some of them are glued to the PCB, and some have a solder square directly underneath them, and you won't know until you actually take off the IC. That's why I always prefer using the Jovi RE7500, because unless I know what's underneath the chip, I could damage it. But anyway, let's give this one a go. I've never taken this chip off before, and let's see. The first thing I do is I heat up the IC. Bring it up to temperature, but keep it moving, don't leave it in one spot, otherwise you'll see a blister appear on the either the IC, or if you stop over the PCB in one spot, it will burn the PCB and damage it, and your board is gone. It will be pretty hard to repair it. You can see the flux burning off. It will start moving. You hear little creaks on it as it starts moving. I'm going to concentrate mostly on these legs right beside the jeweler screwdriver. And then move the fraction, go around the other pins as well slowly. Don't go too quick. Otherwise the solder doesn't melt. And every time it moves, go around this side over here that's not moving. You can see it moving. See, it's starting to take. I'm going to just concentrate on this side now. Don't be tempted to flip it over yet. You'll know when it's going. There you go. Now, that's it off. Switch off my soldering iron. with the IC. And the next thing you have to do then is clean up the PCB. There's not much cleaning to do in this one. The next thing we're going to do now is remove all this solder. And the first thing I do is I just give it a bit more flux to help it on its way. And then I get a good ball of solder on the end of my soldering tip. And what I do then is I just run that ball of solder along the print. And it cleans up most of it. I'm not rubbing the print with the iron. I'm just using the solder to mop up any excess. Now, it's very noisy outside today. We've got the leftovers hitting Europe after the hurricane that hit Bermuda. Now, we can use our flux. I'm just going to increase the temperature of my iron a little bit because it needs a little bit more temperature to work with the flux. Sorry, not the flux, but the wick. And I'm only bringing this over smoothly. I'm not putting any pressure on it. Takes a while for the board to heat up. The area you're in. Does help if you have your board heated up first. Another way you could do it is by putting the heater or the... Another way you can do it is by putting the PCB on a radiator to bring it up to a higher temperature. It does aid for the desoldering process. Then I get a cloth when it's still hot, because it's easy to remove the flux when it's still warm. And then I remove any remainder flux then with my cotton bud. You can also use a small brush to brush away the excess flux. Make sure you get all the flux off. You don't want to corrode the PCB. And don't know if that's getting it or not, but that is the pads cleaned up. There's a few pads on it that still need a little bit more tidying up, but you get the gist. Hope that's of some help to people that have these questions. Thanks for watching.